Webtoons, it's your Webtoons. Webtoons. I cannot say enough awesome stuff about Webtoons. It's a great platform. It has an awesome supportive community and tons of great comics on there that you can read for free, including my own Hacksaw, which you can read now on Webtoons. But yeah, as awesome as Webtoons is, it can be a little daunting at first, especially if you're from a traditional comic format background, because it has the infinite canvas, which is just becomes this huge unwieldy file. And I've done another video where I explain like how I break up my creation process, how I go from thumbnails to art to coloring to lettering and getting a final product completed. So you can see that on YouTube or follow me over on Twitch to check that stuff out. But I wanted to do another video that kind of takes place after that one. Like, how do you take this giant file and get it uploaded to Webtoons? Because they want it in a specific way. They want tiny, like 1,000 pixel high files. And your file is not gonna be 1,000 pixels high. Mine are like 30,000, 60,000 pixels high. So they're huge, and you can't just take that file and upload it to the server. Heck, you can't even save that as like a JPEG or a PNG even. So how do you do it? Well, without much further ado, I'm gonna show you. All right, then we're back. All right, so this is what you're gonna start off with. You're gonna start off with a really humongous file. If you watch my other video, you'll be able to see exactly how we get to this point. And right now I'm using Adobe Photoshop CS4. That's the version I'm running. So this is the size of the first chapter of Hacksaw, which is really a large file. I made this episode way too long. If you want to check out the file specs, this is 800 pixels by 75,000 pixels, which is a lot. Most of my ones now are think around like 40 or 50 maybe. But yeah, so you have this huge file. Check out my other video. I'll link it to kind of show how we got to this point. So if you've been looking at how to submit your comic to Hacksaw, you'll notice that it has to be 800 pixels wide and I think less than 1,000 pixels tall. So if you look at this file being 75,000 pixels tall, it would take forever to select 1,000 pixels and 1,000 pixels and 1,000 pixels and work your way down. Huge, huge pain in the butt. So we're not gonna do that. Now, if you have Photoshop, there's one way to do it. If you don't have Photoshop, there's another way to do it. But if you have Photoshop, you can still do the other way as well. So I'm just gonna focus on the other way. All right, so the first thing we wanna do is figure out how large our file is. And we wanna keep it under, we're gonna need an increment that's less than 30,000 pixels. So we're at 75,000 pixels. You know, let's just round up and say that that is 80,000. That means that we need to split up. Well, actually no, 75. So basically we need to split the file up into three pieces and that will give us about 25,000 pixels for each of the three pieces. If you were using Photoshop, you know, which is an expensive program, there'd be one way you could do it, or the other way. So I'm just going to show you the free way to do it. That should work in any program you're using. So the first thing we want to do is add a guide, and we want to go 33% down. Oops. Add a guide, 33%, and then another guide, 66%. And this basically gives us a way to snap our selections. So you come down and it's gonna snap to that ruler, right? Do a copy all for Photoshop, which is Shift Control C, or you can go to Edit, copy, or copy merged. Create a new file, which is Control N, or go to File, New, obviously, and just paste that in. And so that's gonna pull everything up to your ruler right there. So next thing you wanna do is deselect that and make another selection for this middle part. And hopefully you can see the dancing ants of the selection going right there. So I'm just selecting between these two guides. Select that, do a shift control to do a copy merge. Like if you're using Clip Studio, you don't have to do this. You have to select all your layers and then do the control copy. It's like little tiny variations across all the platforms. But if you're familiar with using your software, it's the concepts that matter, not the actual step-by-step stuff. All right, so now I've created three files that are 25,000-ish pixels tall, right? And if it worked correctly, we can come down here to the very bottom and then come over to this one at the very top, right? And we should see that it cut exactly right in that center spot. So we should be able to take these two images, stick them back together, and it would paste correctly. The other thing you could do, if we're worried about, if it doesn't work out perfectly, is we can, because we have wiggle room, we need it to be less than 30,000 and we're at 25,000, we can get a little tricky and use our move and move the move the ruler into a white space area. That way we know everything. If it doesn't line up perfectly, it won't matter because it's in empty space. So if you have a little bit more empty space, it's not a big deal. Same here, right? We can just take it, move it up a little bit. And bada bing, bada boom, we're good. So, but let's pretend we did that already. I don't want to do all that over again, right? And so now we have three files that are where we need to be to save them as JPEGs, because JPEGs can't be more than 30,000 pixels. So we got these three files. We'll go ahead and save all of them as JPEGs. Right? Split 1, 2, 3. And obviously you want to name these whatever works for your naming convention for your comic. Boom. Okay, so now we have those three files. I'm gonna go ahead and open those. In that location, and here we go. So we have those three files now, and they are still pretty big, but they are valid JPEG sizes. Now the next step is going to be, and it's important, we want to try to keep these under 20 megs, which we're good. If you're under 25,000 pixels and you're 800 pixels wide, you're not gonna go over the 20 meg file size restriction, which you can see here, they're all about 7.5 megs. So we could make them bigger. The only problem is that we can't, then we wouldn't be able to save them as JPEGs. We can, I'm not positive here. You can do a different file format. Let's see. I don't know what restrictions PNGs have, but if we try to save this guy as a PNG, it's not gonna let us anymore. We could save it as a TIFF, but we don't want a TIFF, so we're not gonna worry about that. Now, this is what is gonna save your life, is imagesplitter.net. And I'll put a link down below, or if you know words, you can just type imagesplitter.net. Now what you want to do is go ahead and click not that. You want to click here and then go to where your folder is, right? And pick the first file and go ahead and say upload the image. And you wait for it. And you keep waiting and you're waiting. Obviously, it's 7 megs, so it's going to take a minute to upload. All right. I'm going to edit this. Okay, cool. All right, so the next thing you want to do, now that your file is in here, is click split image. Now, it's going to want to try to split it into half vertically. We don't want to do that, so just put one right there. Now we're here, rows. How many rows do we need? Well, now we gotta do math, right? So there's this other useful app called Calculator, right? And we know we have our files like 25,000, 25,034. And you wanna divide that by 1,000 because Webtoons doesn't want it to be larger than 1,000. So we need to figure out how many thousands are in this. So 25. Which let's go ahead and change it down to 26 rows. That way we know we're rock solid on the row count. And then we pick which one we want. I'm good with JPEG, but if you want something else, pick it. I don't care. JPEG's just fast. So you split the image. And now it's going to take a while to run and do its thing. You can see down here it's downloading, right? And boom, there you go. So this is the file, and here are all of the things. And I'm gonna go ahead, and you can see that it's split into 26 files, starting with zero, because that's how tech does it. We start at zero. And then let's go ahead and take all these and paste it back over here so we can have a clean view of stuff. Stop it, there we go. All right, call that one, and then we'll go in and paste all those little lovelies in there. So now you see we have 25 files, and it is details 800 by 962 pixels. And hopefully it did a good job of splitting it for us. Right where it needs to be. If we look here, it's like got that little piece. I'm trying to see if there's, it's kind of right there where that pipe and that line meet. So there's the pipe and there's the line. So it looks pretty good. All right, so now we have our files. We would have to do this process here 3 times because we have 3 files. So let's just pretend I did that. And we're good to go. The other thing to note is if your file is less than 30,000, you can save straight to a JPEG from whatever program you're using and go straight to Image Splitter. The important thing is that you take your file, your huge long file here, right, this monster, and you get it into increments less than 30,000 pixels so that you can save it as a JPEG or a PNG, and you can use it on imagesplitter.net. So looking at another program like Clip Studio, which if you can't afford Photoshop, I would recommend Clip Studio. And some people can't afford Clip Studio, we can start looking at some of the free options. And I'll post links to those down below too. I don't use those, I'm using Clip Studio mostly. And I have a very old version of Photoshop. Or you can do their monthly installment thing. I mean, if you're doing art seriously, like 10 bucks a month for Photoshop isn't too bad. You know, it's like 2 cups of coffee a month. Or not fast food, you know? But anyways, I digress. So it would be pretty much the same thing here, right? you know how big your file is. Like you go, this is Clip Studio, you go here, you check the image resolution, and you're at 42,000 pixels. So this is one of my more recent episodes, so you can see I've already shrunk the size a lot. I'm not doing 75,000 pixels tall anymore. This is at 42, so nearly half, or close enough to half for me to say half. You would do it the same way. You'd figure out where halfway is. I don't know if Clip Studio does automatic grids for you or not, or automatic rulers for you. It doesn't look like it. I'm not seeing anything about guides. So you would kind of have to eyeball it. You know your file is 42,000. So in this case, we could just split it in half to make it easy on ourselves. So you grab up in the ruler up here, you just click in the ruler and drag down and just stick it somewhere in the middle where there isn't overlap, and just put it somewhere halfway. Obviously you're gonna have to be more specific if you have huge file, but otherwise just go in there and slap it down. And then you can go in and be like, okay, that's a good spot. I don't know if you can move rulers. Okay, so you can move rulers in Clip Studio too. Just use the V to get the move tool, or it's right here. Boom, boom, boom. So you can move that. And then it's gonna do the exact same thing as Photoshop. You just drag and it clicks to that thing. And then all you do for Clip Studio, you're gonna have to annoyingly just select all of the layers like so, and then do Control C and do new. Actually, you can, another weird thing is it doesn't automatically pick up your file size from your clipboard. So you do create from clipboard, and that will give you the size, and then paste it auto magically into that. And then at this point, it's the same thing as Photoshop. You just save this as a JPEG, pull it over into Image Splitter, and you're good to go. So the other programs that there are is there's Krita, K-R-I-T-A, Medibang, and Gimp Studio. I have not used these programs. It's going to be fairly similar to how it works in Clip Studio and Photoshop. I don't know how large of a file size those three programs support. So you may have already found workarounds to get the large infinite canvas working for those pieces of software. In which case you can probably figure out how to get it shrunk down to less than 30,000 pixels so you can save it as a JPEG. You might be working in multiple files. It might support giant long files as well. Some of them might open Photoshop files or large Photoshop documents, which is what I use for Photoshop. So you'll have that information, but basically that's it. Get it under 30,000 pixels, save it as a JPEG, pull it up in Image Splitter, and off to the races you go. Then you just take all of these files, and just upload them like a madman into Webtoon. And that's it. Then you're good to go. And that's all we got. So if you have any questions about Webtoons or anything about drawing or whatever, I don't care what I had for breakfast, just comment below and I will happily answer. I'm always checking my stuff. Otherwise, please be sure to like the video, subscribe, check me out on Twitch, subscribe there. I'm always drawing comics or commissions, and I try to help as much as possible. If you want to get on my Discord, you can show off your art there and ask for crits or anything that you want. So I think I'll go ahead and leave it there. I hope this was helpful. I hope you start splitting up your files for Webtoons and start posting your Webtoon. If this did help and you do post your comic on Webtoon, go ahead and comment below so I can check the comic out. I'd love to check it out. I love checking out new comics. Yada, yada, yada. Blah, 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 blah. Until next time, peace.